All right, we're in there. We're in grand finals. We got Prycook solo commentary for doubles. It's gonna be pretty good, right? So yeah, we got Van once again wearing the free ISIS tag. Thanks, Van. With his partner G-Money as a Falco versus Grab and Go. I saw my first Grab and Go like last week coming home from New York. I was like, shit, oh, that's actually a reference to something. I don't know, I think it's like a 7-Eleven or some shit. Grab and Go. What? Okay. Whatever. Anyway, we got the weirdest edge guard from, wait, was that the moon or DJ? They kind of switch mains sometimes. I guess that's the moon, since DJ's more likely to be playing sheep. Redu is playing sheep. Nice from DJ getting back to his stage. If that were singles, he wouldn't have made it back, you know? There would have been somebody there to edge guard him if it wasn't. There's a lot more kind of different situations. G-Money just lost his stock to his teammate, Van, singular Van. See, like, he wears Van's shoes, but I guess he lost one of his shoes, so he's only got a Van now. That could have been like a rest out of shield, but probably wouldn't have killed anyway. I guess it doesn't matter. Now Puff dies off the top, Jiglooing, because Jiglooing's a balloon. Good? Alright. Sorry, a bit of audio quality issues. Yo, what? Let's get some commentary! Dude, the people want to hear J-Sex commentary. Yeah, well... Dude, this is our stream. We can curse. We can curse. Yeah, you can curse. Yeah, say whatever you want. Take the mic. J-Sex not wanting to commentate. Too bad for the viewers, that would have been quite the improvement of what you're hearing right now. DOH isn't there according to the challenge. Somebody should fix that. Unless he's not here because I actually didn't see him. Anyway, we've got a bit of a hurdle for the green team. They're gonna have to take like a couple cheek stocks because DJ's been tanking here. Without this fragile Falco dying. Which is also going to be a bit of a challenge. And the Falco is dead. Rather. Buff's going to have a hard time. Probably not going to be able to recover. Yep, unable to recover. Alright, so game one goes to Grab and Go. There's like 40 really good people there. It's not hard to accidentally leave a good player out or two. Surviving. Alright, so we got a switch. Vance going Peach from Puff. Wonder what that's about. Alright, G-Money kind of fails his shield pressure there. We got a weird sort of stage control action happening here, but it's not weird. But green team was holding the center for quite a bit. Yeah, and they still are. Pretty nice. Bit of a struggle. And look, now red team is on the edge. G-Money messes up somehow and ends up off stage and dies. Wow, everybody wants to be on the same platform. I mean, I know the platforms are wide, but I don't think they're that wide. Not as wide as Battlefield. That actually might be the thing. It's one of my songs now. I don't know. Alright, now we have the monumental task of edge grinding Peach. It doesn't really work. It's hard enough in singles, let alone doubles. Oh, that could have been something. Wow, and so Vance tries to save his teammate, but I don't know. I guess something in him told him to dare and then back air. And actually Edge guards his teammate instead. He's and now he has these. We got some clubs going on. Huh. That was nice. DJ should have thrown more needles there. IMO. Better? Okay. Yeah, I don't know if I keep moving the mic away from my mouth or what. I don't know. Anyway. That tipper would have been destruction. Was that a sticky wall? Is that what I saw? Good match. I actually think Peach's recovery is like the best in doubles. Yeah, another flub from Van. I'm getting my Van. Alright, everybody's down to the last stock. There won't be any stock ceiling under that shit. We're gonna. And whoever takes the first stock, or, you know, whichever team loses the first stock is probably gonna lose the next one. Probably gonna lose the game. Alright, we got the red team cornered. Pretty good screen. Trying to make some space, trying to get inside. We made it. This is going to be a bit of a struggle for the red team, but they're both at high percent. It happened though. And they end up, and Grab and Go ends up losing a stock. And now DJ has to 1v2. Then G Money with the high percent sheep. Didn't happen though. Yeah, I think because we're running this from a loader, they kind of play the victory animation at separate times. So it kind of sounds weirder than what you would hear. And, what's this draw pull about? Clicked. Fave console. Alright, I don't really give a shit. Yo, where's the... This is an iPad. Where's, like, the return? Because I'm trying to... Oh, you have to do that? Okay. Alright, so... maybe we should just ban that person. Nobody gives a shit about favorite console. We're trying to start a console war. Are we, like, 13? What's up?
I'm trying to talk to you and him.
Yeah, but you gotta commentate, dude. Alright, Working's busy talking to Bob.
Oh, the Ryo Brad thing's a joke. Man, people don't get jokes. People don't get jokes.
Ryo Brad is Ryo Green. I mean, there's, it's possible that was a typo.
No, that's a joke.
I mean, I know it wasn't, but it's possible because, you know, he is right next to R. It's not like J sucks, right?
Yeah.
It's because the U is far away from the E. J sucks is an intentional misspelling.
Oh my god, he just got a bomb kill.
That just looks so casual. Just items, like bombs exploding. We got a stage like this, big wall jutting out in the middle. And we got four men on the...
Uh-oh, here we go, infinite? Nope. Oh, it does get the up smash kills with it, though.
I was looking at what was going on with the edge guard between Vance and DJ. When you said infinite, and I got excited.
He was about to do the drill shine.
Yeah.
But then, messed it up. stunned.
Got excited though.
He did get the kill though, so that's all that matters.
Wow, I wouldn't expect that to work. I guess I'm not sure.
Oh, rest in peace. That's gonna tie it up with first stocks, but you know, green team sitting with a nice percent lead.
How are you gonna make it back?
Oh, edge guard. Nope.
Both grab and go seem to be good at getting out of rough spots in teams.
Yeah, I feel like Marth and Sheik can cover each other while the other one like tries to get out or do his own.
I mean,
own
like even individually, you know, they'll stall the ledge until it's hit.
Okay, so DJ just kind of got caught sitting in his shield. I like that he's wearing the free Icy's tag.
Yeah, it's a good tag.
Even though Icy's are free today, you can wobble.
That's nice. But they'll never truly be free until they can freeze glitch.
I don't know, I think freeze glitch is kind of...
Yeah, I know. It's whatever.
Because there's no chance of you messing it up once it happens.
Yeah, well... It's never really a balance issue, it's just a stalling issue. It's always been the case.
And plus your opponent can get stuck into an inescapable position.
Not if you're smart. They do it.
They might
Japan.
Do it on purpose to like...
No, but that's a forfeit. You don't think they thought of that? It says in the rules that's a forfeit if you can't reach them. So that even means that if you're SDI, like, be unreachable, you still lose.
Alright, but like, what happens if you get stuck at the top of stadium? And then like
you don't just don't throw up. Oh, that's
the
with the transformation.
Like, yeah, it's a
whatever. It's a forfeit.
No, but like
it's
and then
you take, dude.
The ICs can just like refuse to like hit them and
yeah,
allow them to SDI.
Yeah, that's a forfeit.
Down. So they're forced to forfeit even though
yeah,
it's
that's
not
a forfeit.
That's not fair.
How's that not fair?
Wait, who's forfeiting the ICs, right?
Yeah.
Oh,
if you freeze glitch them and they're out of reach, yeah, that's a forfeit.
Okay. I was thinking like the other person.
Yeah, no, that would be bad. So it's in the Ice Climber's best interest to always do a forward throw freeze glitch and always deal damage with back throw or down throw. So that's what they do. Anyway. A little bit of chaos. But you know what? That would have been chaotic if it were like me. Me and that on that screen, just with like four people along the corner, definitely some good stuff.
Oh, okay. So Moon got that nice forward smash.
Yeah, Lime J. What do you like about teams? I agree with Sam Jacobs.
I mean, you play teams every time.
Yeah. What? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yo.
Oh, we got this already.
This is Vino and Smokey on the mic.
Sup? I'm assuming this is set one. So
yeah.
Game four.
Yeah. Game four, set one.
There's an eggplant here.
Yeah, we have like this eggplant. It's just like at the commentating
yeah,
station.
Yeah. Okay. Whatever. That's great. Back to the match.
Back to the match. Okay. So G Money messed up on that Shino stall, fire stall. Dude. What's up?
G Money did. All right. Who's playing? Okay. What? Is DJ playing Sheik?
Yeah, okay, so let's just talk about the characters for a second. DJ is a Fox main, but he's playing Sheik right now. His Sheik's really good. It's really technical, too.
I thought Vance might be playing Sheik.
No.
Yeah,
Vance
okay.
is his signature Peach.
Okay.
G-Money
and
is Fox.
G-Fox.
Yeah.
Okay. That was.
I think G-Money's Falco is a lot better than his Fox.
Oh,
honestly.
Definitely. But he believes in the G-Fox.
Yeah, I don't know why.
It could be solid in teams. I mean, we played it in teams, and it was pretty good. It was pretty good in teams. I mean, like, at my house... during, you know, for friendlies.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I've never seen him whip it out in bracket.
Okay, Van's walling out Ryan into the Moon into the corner, and now switching to pressure on DJ, who's also in the corner.
Yeah, Van's kind of a weird peach.
He's really good though at like switching in between DJ and Moon. Like,
he's super good at it. It's and I'm glad you pointed it out. I think it's like one of his strongest qualities in teams is just like his ability to switch between who's attacking. So DJ will see him hitting the moon and he's thinking himself.
Wait. Did you guys? I'm sorry. Right, so
go for it.
G Money. DJ was cheap, edge guarding G Money.
Right.
And then the moon smashed Vans high up into the top right corner. DJ traded with G Money's Firefox with a back air. And it hit DJ up into Vans, and then he forward aired Vans and killed him. And yeah, we got.
That's the eggplant.
Yeah.
I don't know why, Terry.
No, because Fry Cook's an ice climber's main.
Oh, okay. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah.
Okay, Dreamman.
Oh, yeah, like I was saying, his ability to just, you know, DJ, he's attacking DJ, and the moon thinks, oh, he's going to keep comboing DJ, and he doesn't. You know what I mean? He switches and hits DJ. DJ is caught by surprise, maybe doesn't DI, you know, too ideally.
And right there, like, great edge guard, great team, great edge guard on G Money, and then team edge guard on Vans.
Yeah. G Money switching to Falco.
Yeah, maybe Pokemon Stadium was just like a, you know, that was why he went Fox, because Fox is gonna kill so early on that stage. But G Money has been on that platform for a while, and he's not getting off. Oh my God, these combos on G Money.
Yeah. Speaking of getting kills early, you can get kills really early on Falco. And that was just like a kind of like.
Oh, I don't know why he... Okay, that's it.
Yeah.
Dude!
That was great.
That was a great team edge guard.
Yeah.
Sheik, DJ covered the ledge by running off and fairing, and then the moon covered the high option, and then DJ finished it. And that was amazing! Dude, DJ Sheik is so good.
Yeah,
It was good. Great tech by G-Money, too.
There's, like, so much trust in between DJ and the moon. It's like, I know I hit him, and I know I can follow up with something, but I know you're going to follow up with something. And, you know, you'll just be in a better position for it, or you'll get more done.
And right there, really smart. G Money forward beat into the moon to try to get caught by his upbeat. The moon waited until G Money fell too low to upbeat.
G Money just missed that opportunity. That could have been some juicy percent on Ashi.
I feel like they're doing a really good job at, like, teaming up on the Falco. Even though right there you saw 2 1-on-1s. Because, I mean, Peach off the stage against Marth is just... Marth can have so much fun with her.
Teams, like, if you know when to do the one-on-ones, and you know when to do... And one of the times you do the one-on-ones is if you're edgeguarding somebody, you know what I mean? If you have one person just making sure the other person can't get to your teammate who is edgeguarding.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's always kind of sad when you see, like, I remember there was a video, I think, of Ken and Isaiah, where Ken and Isaiah both had their opponents each in a grab. It was just like, what are you gonna do? Oh, what? That was a good trade. They were stock up.
That was a good trade for DJ and the Moon.
Yeah. That was a good trade for DJ and the Moon because they were stock up.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. The Moon getting out of there. But that equalizer.
Yeah, dude, that was 45%. I believe.
And then Vans
that
with the pressure.
That was ultra cute with Vans.
Yeah. Man, Vans is so aggressive as a Peach. But okay, nice.
And he's so good with those double jig canceled nairs.
Yeah.
Or the like quickly floated nairs. I'm not sure which one he's doing, but he sure is doing it well.
Yeah. Now, I Vance is at 100, but he can live for a very long time. This is Dreamland. That's why I would have liked if DJ won Fox, honestly.
Oh, this is happening, dude. This is a comeback in the works.
Yeah, this is super close.
G Money needs to make sure he doesn't die, which he's been pretty good with since the first stock. Yeah, I've been dying at 12%. And this is gonna be rough. Oh!
Oh, let's nice. The moon really didn't want to commit to anything. And Vance is like floating towards the moon.
That's it. Oh!
No, that's not it. That 10% sent him off.
Oh!
No! DJ! The moon! That, okay,
And Vance really should. I feel like Vance should have gone for the moon there, but.
Okay, that's it.
Daps all around. I gotta play the moon, so I'm gonna do that on stream right now.
Okay.
Yeah.